The children of Greystone played hide and seek every day. Until one day, when a strange girl appeared out of nowhere.
Hey, can I play?
Sure, I guess so.
You know what would be really fun? Instead of counting, say this.
Written on the paper was a chanting rhyme. The girl hesitated. But then she started chanting, changing their lives forever.
I lost my dad and my brother when I was just a kid. Mom and I moved to a new town after that. We've lived here ever since. Mom's funeral was yesterday. Today, I'm cleaning her house, remembering our past. A letter from Dad. Mom, why didn't you tell me? Mom keeps all of Dad's things in the attic. If there are more letters... They must be up here! I haven't been up here in ages. So many memories and old scars. after all this time, Dad is alive? After Tom disappeared, Dad went looking for him, but he never returned. I need to know the truth. I'm going back to Greystone. What was that? Thank goodness I didn't hit the fountain.
I already told the others. I can't help anyone until I've finished my research. Sorry, thought you were another local. I'm Victor Quaid, you know, the famous meteorologist. Well, my groundbreaking research is the only way to find those missing people. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Ah, my scar. It's glowing.
What now? Oh, it's you again. Who are you, anyway? What? You're Jack's daughter? Well, pleased to meet you. Sorry, this isn't exactly a town of sharp conversations, if you catch my drift. Your father has fierce determination. When everyone gave up, your father stayed. He's certainly been a help to me. He's working on the Great Gate, over there. I won't keep you. Tell him I said hello.
Hey, could you give me a hand with this hunk of junk? It won't budge. Is it really you? There's so much to say, but there's no time. You need to leave. It's too dangerous. No! She's coming! Run! Listen to me. She's coming for you. Memorize this number, 6215. Remember, 6215. Now run before she...
No! Dad! My scar. It's getting brighter.
Thank you. I count 1, 2, and 3. You better hide while I can't see. 4, then 5, then I say 6. My friend has a lot of tricks. After 7 comes 8, then 9. Hide or run, you will be mine. The fog falls as I count 10. You won't ever leave again.
The fog took them all, even my brother Tom. Then a glowing symbol burned into my palm. I escaped. But I was the only one.
Once upon a time, there was a lonely orphan. She tried to make friends, but the other children ignored her. While they played hide and seek, she wandered into the forest. One day, she went into the heart of the forest where the spirits gather. One spirit took pity on the lonely girl, sharing a part of its power. The girl reveled in her new abilities as an idea formed in her mind.
The fog is making my scar glow brighter.
There's something at the base of that creepy scarecrow.
Did you see that? Wait, Victor mentioned you. You can stop it, right? Since you arrived, the fog's gotten worse. Everyone's saying it's your fault. Well, is it? You don't know? I thought everyone knew the statue has the key. Actually, getting it is another thing. Victor knows how, but good luck getting him to tell you. By the way, my key is missing. I think it's in the shop. If you find it, I'll open the back street gate for you.
Thank you.
Oh, that's it. Here, I'll unlock the back street gate for you.
That was a close one. My scar just keeps getting brighter whenever that fog is around. I saw someone moving through the fog. Who is that girl?
What do we have here? Back away from the table, slowly. Now, get in the elevator. She promised to give my boy back if I bring you to her. You're going in that fog, and my son is coming out. It's a fair trade. You don't know how long I've waited, how I've suffered. Now move to the fountain. We will meet with her there.
That was close. Well, I guess I have no choice now but to find my way out of the forest.
Excuse me, I'm looking for my sister. We were playing hide and seek, and she disappeared. I've been looking for an hour, but I can't find her anywhere. Sis? What happened to you? You got so old.
Tom, you have no idea how long we've...
Oh, good. You found another one. Now we can play again. See if you can find me.
No!
It's never wise to rush into the foggy woods, especially if that really was her who passed by earlier. It's all right. I'm here to help you. And all those lost in the fog. If you want to go after her, you'll need light to repel the fog. If you find a lantern, I'll light it for you. This map will help you get your bearings. Thank you. Good. You found one. Let me just light it for you. The lantern is still too weak against the fog, but the light can be boosted with fire flowers. The one you seek is at the old windmill past the foggy woods.
My leg. I think it's broken. Can you help me? Oh, it's you. I followed you into the woods and saw what happened. Then I tracked the girl here. I'm so sorry for what I did. I had no choice. She tricked me. Please, I need some support for my leg.
Thank you.
my favorite spot to hide. The miller used to let me hide in the back of the mill. His name was Jacob.
Thank you.
Thank you. I need to go rest now. Let's go inside. I'll tell you everything. You're very kind, and I am truly sorry. If you've read my notebook, then you know about my son. I kept the last page of the notebook and some photos of Eric. It's all I have left of him now. Can you help me? Will you try to find Eric? Oh, thank you. Now, listen carefully. Everything started in the town of Hope's Edge.
Dad? Dad, I found you!
Stop! Don't touch him! I tried to warn you. The scar on your hand is a seeker's mark. The people you touch turn into pearls. There's still hope. But you have to keep the pearls away from her at all costs. I wish I could, but time is of the essence if you want to find answers. Take the cable car up over the cliff outside. It's the quickest way to Hope's Edge. And take this with you.
In the town of Hope's Edge lived a little boy whose father was often away on business trips.
The boy had no friends, and with his father gone, he was very lonely. But one day, a little girl approached him and asked if he would like to play hide and seek. The boy quickly agreed. The girl made him the seeker and said she would find more friends to play with. She summoned a thick fog. It enveloped the town and its citizens. When she returned to the boy, she said that everyone was hidden in the fog, waiting to play.
Thank you.
Hope's Edge, using the cable car, is over the windmill, the waterfall, and a small hamlet. It's not the shortest route, but the others are too dangerous.
Thank you. Oh, hello. Excuse my confusion. We don't get many visitors in this place. I was fixing the hot air balloon back there. My father is, waiting. Why are you here anyway? I see. Well, there's nobody else in town, but House 14 might be of some interest to you. Oh, before I go, I built something you might find intriguing. It's at the souvenir shop. This will activate it.
Okay. Angela was gone, but the fog remained. To make an anti-fog lamp, I needed a bulb from one of the town's streetlights. I recently learned that the fog is repelled by fireflower essence. I decided to add some to the lamps. My invention worked well enough until the wind picked up. I had to find a casing to protect the flowers. The fog still surrounded the town. I couldn't leave. Longing for a friend and helper, I decided to modify a robot I had found. First, I needed a pair of identical arms to make him dexterous. To make him fast but stable, I needed two matching propellers. I started thinking about how to find my father. I knew Hope's Edge had a hot air balloon and soon found the basket. But I still needed a full propane tank to heat up the air. All I need now is a balloon. Then I'll rise above the fog and go find my father. I know we'll be together again soon. Note to self, I put the little boat from the picture inside the tape reel of this recording.
Up, especially the clocks. But they always keep their secrets behind the odd one out.
It didn't take long for the boy to find the first person hiding. But when he touched them, they turned into a small pearl. The girl placed the pearl on her necklace and told the boy not to worry. She said that the pearls represented true friendship
and urged him to find more. The boy continued seeking and eventually found everyone hiding in Hope's Edge. Each person he found turned into a pearl, and he gave them all to the girl for her necklace.
Initiating self-destruct sequence. 4, 3, 2, 1. Ha ha. Just kidding, miss. Welcome to the Hope's Edge souvenir shop. If you have coupons, place them into the slot on my hole to win a prize. I also take coins. They will be converted into tokens for the amusement park. Congratulations, miss. For 6 coupons, you get this lighter, an original souvenir from Hope's Edge.
Please, don't go in there. It's the auxiliary room, and it's not safe. Please, don't go in there. It's the auxiliary room, and it's not safe. You too? What a nightmare. And it's all my fault. Everything happened because of me. She said she just wanted to play, but the fog came with her. It took everyone, including my father. He is? Thank you. I'm going to find him right now. The balloon is yours, if you can repair it. Oh, and about that girl, Angela, she used to live in Sunny Valley. Try looking there.
Thank you.
Oh, my head. I'm lucky to be alive.
Thank you. Once a year, we played a game of hide and seek. You could only win if you found at least 3 of your friends. Each person you found gave you a pearl as a symbol of true friendship. We kept the pearls in a special friendship bag. If you had a lot of pearls at the end of the game, it meant you had a lot of friends. We cherished them and kept them close to our heart.
But Angela didn't have any friends. A small bunny was the only companion she ever had. She wandered through the forest alone. Near the old windmill, she met spirits who took pity on her. But there was a catch. To get her powers, Angela had to agree never to play with children or lay a hand on them again. As time passed, she became sad and longed for company. When she thought of it, her eyes would fill with tears. Having pearls meant having friends. So Angela got an idea for her own game of hide and seek. She soon went looking for children at their houses. She needed a child to seek in her place. Then she could use her powers to capture whoever they found inside a pearl, keeping them with her forever.
Time passed, and as they sat under the tree where all of the pearls hung, the boy began to feel uneasy. He wondered how long the people would stay inside the pearls, and when they would turn back to normal. Surprised, the girl told him they would never be returned. The pearls were their friends now. The boy was horrified. He ran away, swearing he would never play with her again. Hurt and angry, the girl left Hope's Edge, leaving the boy all alone in town. But soon, the girl found another town, and another child to be her seeker.
It's time for the last game of hide and seek. Whoever wins gets all the friends.
Hey, she threw me out. I have to get back in there.
Think you could take my friends away from me? You will never have them! One less won't make a difference.
Thank you. again when I'm done with you! Find these friends in the first place. Why are you trying to take them? Been alone all my life. Never again.
I'm all alone now. My mother is gone. My father lies here. And you took all my friends away.